Shell has set a target to become a net zero emissions business by 2050. We have several roles to play. We are a producer of energy, we are a user of energy, and we are a seller of energy and therefore a partner of change. Producing immersion coolants is an important part of that because that allows us to sell more products that help other industries emit less carbon.
Today, 99% of data centers are air-cooled, which means that from an efficiency perspective and sustainability, it's not the best.
When you're developing next-generation solutions, the theory is one thing, but what you really want is you want to see it in practice. Having this immersion cooling solution deployed in our data center really allows people to see that it works on the ground.
So what we do is we take a tank of lubricant and we take the server and we rotate it and we immerse it fully into the lubricant.
The analogy that I would actually use is imagine on a hot day in Houston, standing in front of a handheld fan to try and cool yourself up and jumping in a pool. The most effective way of cooling off in that moment is jumping in the pool. And for me, immersion cooling is very similar. So air cooling versus immersing. You put your servers into that liquid and you take the heat out a lot faster.
This cluster that we've built with AMD EPYC technology and immersion cooling is an example of a very dense cluster that would be impossible to build if we didn't immerse it.
If I had tried to do this with air cooling, I would need three times as many racks, which means I need three times as much power distribution, three times as much floor space, three times as much networking. Being able to keep a small footprint is critical.
Well, I think the power of collaboration and partnerships like the one we celebrate today with Penguin, AMD, and Shell is to truly demonstrate that these solutions work. And how can we leverage technology in a way that is fully sustainable and ensures that we can continue to progress as a population?